What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So, I'm going to be doing my Royal Rumble preview and predictions. Pay-per-view is this Saturday. Most likely, we will be checking it out, doing a live stream reactions on the In the Clutch main page. So, be on the lookout for that. It's going to be a fun time. We will see how things play out. Hopefully, Dub doesn't get too upset when he sees Brock Lesnar going against Bobby Lashley. So, this should be a good time. So, be on the lookout for that. And it's going to be fun, man. But let's get into my preview and predictions. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I didn't even know who was in the men's and women's Royal Rumble matches. I don't know who's in it. So I'm looking this up right now on DAZN News or whatnot. And I don't think they have all the entrances as well. And plus, things are probably subject to change. The card may change. I'm filming this on Thursday, so maybe the card will change tomorrow on SmackDown. We will see. But we're going to go through the match card, and I'm going to give my thoughts and opinions on who's going to win, who's going to lose, why and why not. Let's get right into it. So, for the men's side of things, the participants they have are Randy Orton, Riddle, Kevin Owens, Happy Corbin, Madcap Moss, AJ Styles, Rey Mysterio, Dominic Mysterio, Austin Theory, Johnny Knoxville, woo, Kofi Kingston, Big E, Damian Priest, Sheamus, Sami Zayn, Omos, Montez Ford, Angelo Dawkins, Chad Gable, Otis, Dolph Ziggler, Robert Roode. Alright, that's on the men's side of things. I don't know, man. Out of the men's, just what they've named right here, I don't know. I don't know who wins this. I'm being super serious. I have no idea who wins this. I don't. I haven't really been following enough to really tell. And I just, from the things I have been seeing on Raw and SmackDown, the focus is not really on the men's Royal Rumble like it should be. You can kind of usually tell who's WWE's kind of backing in the Royal Rumble. You could, when Drew was going to be in the Royal Rumble that year, he won. You can kind of tell WWE was backing him, how they were kind of pushing him. So I don't know here. If I had to choose, who would I like to win it? I would like AJ Styles to win it. I think that would be pretty cool. My only problem with that is I think they're trying to build up a feud with him and Omos. So I know they've split as a tag team. So they may be trying to go with that feud. So I don't know if that's going to happen. But I would like AJ Styles to win it. I think that would be so cool. Or maybe Damian Priest. I think that would be a nice little rub for him. Damian Priest getting the win there. So if I had to choose, AJ Styles, Damian Priest would be my choices, but I would probably go with AJ Styles. Hopefully that would be something cool, but once again, I think they're probably gonna go with him and Omos probably facing each other at WrestleMania. Who knows? So the women's Royal Rumble match participants include Carmella, Dana Brooke, Nikki Ash, Queen Zelina, Rhea Ripley, Tamina, Aaliyah, Charlotte Flair, Naomi, Natalya, who else? Shayna Baszler, Shotzi, Brie Bella, Lita, Nikki Bella, Kelly Kelly, Michelle McCool, Mickey James, Summer Rae, Bianca Belair, Liv Morgan. So I just realized something. Charlotte Flair is still the SmackDown's women champion, and she's in the women's Royal Rumble match. I'm trying to figure out why. I don't know if this was an error or a typo, but once again, I wouldn't put it past WWE to have a champion, a main champion, in the match to what? I guess heighten up the match. Maybe she could win the Rumble and face Becky out for the belt. I don't know, bro. I legitimately, at this point, when it comes to their booking decisions, I really don't understand. I can't really fathom what be going on in their creative minds, or lack thereof creative minds. But if I was to choose, I would like Liv Morgan to win. Do I think she will win? No. But that would be my pick for her to win. If anyone else, probably Shayna Baszler. But I think Liv Morgan is a crowd favorite right now. So I do think she should get the win, and potentially end up facing Becky again, or maybe Charlotte for the title. But if you guys seen my recent video of rumors of Ronda coming back, if Ronda comes back, it doesn't matter who's on this list, she winning it. So it kind of just messes over everybody else. So we will see if that happens. But if Ronda doesn't come back, I'm going for Liv Morgan to win it. We got the Becky Lynch versus Doudrop singles match for the Raw Women's Championship. I didn't even know this was a thing. This is a piss break match. No disrespect, but I don't care. I don't, bro. I can't take Doudrop seriously. The name I can't even take seriously. I don't care. Becky retains. Are we going to be surprised? Like I said, that's going to be the piss break match. I'm just telling you this now. Edge and Beth Phoenix versus Miz and Maryse mixed tag. Honestly, I want this feud to freaking end. I do. I don't think this needs to continue. Edge, Beth Phoenix win. End this feud with Edge so he can get into something better. Because it should have been a one and done when he beat The Miz. Boom. Done. Over. I'm done with it. So, now we get to the nitty gritty. Brock with Paul Heyman versus Bobby Lashley with MVP for the WWE Championship. This is going to be an interesting one. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I would love for Bobby Lashley to win. I think that would be a much needed win for him. Right now, the story that they're telling is Brock doesn't give two F's about Bobby Lashley. He thinks he's a joke. He does not take him seriously at all. Doesn't. And if you guys have kind of looked at Brock's past opponents, a lot of his opponents he didn't really take seriously, and it never really ended well for them. In this situation, he doesn't take him seriously, and I don't think it will end well for him. Would I want him to win? Yes, but I just have a feeling that the match is probably going to be at least 5 to 7 minutes long. It's not going to be no wrestling clinic like some of you guys think it will be. I just don't see it happening. I would love for it to be something really intense, but this match was built on the fly, man. Not really much build to it other than Brock's having a good time, doesn't really care about Bobby Lashley. He thinks he's a joke, and I just think Bobby is he's going to lose. I hope he doesn't get squashed. If he gets squashed, I will be ranting about it because I don't think he deserves to get squashed, but I don't think the match is going to be that long, to be honest with you, and I think Brock Lesnar will retain, so that's where it's looking like. I'm pretty sure Dub is going to be sick. So, yeah, I think Brock is going to retain there. And we'll see what happens afterwards leading to WrestleMania. And then, of course, Roman Reigns versus Seth freaking Rollins. Roman should win. Roman should retain. I like Seth. And I know a lot of you guys, oh, Seth should win. No. Roman needs to retain. I'm sorry. Seth is not the guy to beat Roman. And if he does beat Roman, that means Roman literally beat all these future Hall of Famers just to lose to Seth again. Like, if you're going to have a character change as big as Roman's character change was from the times that he was facing Rollins and losing to where he is now, he should not be losing. And he should win clean because the Usos will not be allowed to be at ringside. He needs to win clean and call it a day. I'm just sorry. Seth should not be the guy that takes down a 500-plus title reign. I'm sorry. No matter how much you guys want Seth to do it, oh, it makes sense. It doesn't make sense. I want you guys to remember, Seth was on SmackDown when Roman was tearing through people. If that was the case, they should have gave it to him then. He was still a heel at that time. This is not even supposed to be happening because of what happened at WWE Day 1 and Drew McIntyre getting injured. I think Drew was supposed to be in this spot right now. Drew was supposed to potentially have this match. I think that's really what it was supposed to be, in my opinion. Drew was supposed to have this match. They were supposed to be building a storyline with Drew, but he's out for now. So yeah, they pretty much, this is a substitute match. I do not think Seth will win. He should not win. And that's just my personal opinion on it. If you're going to give someone the title to the Universal Championship, it got to be somebody that's going to really benefit from it. Seth is already a made man. I've already said this before. He will not benefit from it like you think he will. He's already a made man in the company. He's already a top guy. This needs to go to someone that can really, it will really boost their character. It will really boost them up from a fan standpoint. Like, damn, he's the guy that did it. He's the guy to beat Roman. Holy, he's the next guy up. That's how it should be. So that's just my thoughts and predictions on this year's Royal Rumble. It's kind of lackluster just card-wise, only because, you know, we're supposed to really be hyped up for the men's and women's Royal Rumble. And I don't know. It's kind of meh for me, to be honest with you. I think they put more effort into the Brock and Paul Heyman, Bobby Lashley situation, and Roman and Seth Rollins. They've put a lot of their time and effort into that instead of really building up the hype for this year's Royal Rumble on the men and women side of things. So comment down below. Let me know, who do you guys think will win the men's and women's Royal Rumble? Who do you guys think will win their respective matches? Why do you think these individuals will win? And where do you think these storylines are going to lead to in the upcoming months, man? But I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 70K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all on the next one. Peace.